Hello everyone, welcome back to the Create series with me, Zanaf, and I am looking so much more steampunkier than before, thanks to Liara for making me a wonderful, wonderful skin, which I've got to say, I'm going to get very attached to these clothes. It's all steam in the front and punk in the back. We also now have the top of the windmill built as well, and doesn't this thing just look incredible? It's so cool and spinny. I kind of want it to go faster even. I want this thing to go so quickly that the house just like flies away off into the sky. But anyway, we have a bunch of stuff to show off real quick of what I've been doing between episodes. We obviously have our spinny utility tiles, which I have now created. Look at that. Did you see the floor? This little floor right in between. Ha! In between the different things, there is no longer a hole in the ground. That is simply another minecart contraption that's just static. Can I see it over here? They're kind of overlapping each other. It's a little bit weird. Yeah, it's this one. It's literally just a platform with a load of slabs on it that doesn't move. It doesn't do anything, but it just means that we don't see a big gaping hole in the floor whilst we're spinning our utility tiles around. We just see a nice little bit of floor there. Found my pants as well. They had flown off outside, so the bed and the pants are still a little bit broken, but you know, maybe one day they'll be fixed. We now also have an upstairs, which is our main living area. Boom, look at this stuff up here. It's so much room for activities. We can see the windmill going on through the wind. Oh, over there, too many wind-related items. I've brought all my stuff up here, and we've got a load more things. I got some resource gathering done. And then we have this, my wonderful ore washing machine, which do you see it? Do you know exactly what this looks like? Pause the video now and comment if you think you know what this looks like. I'm gonna say it. It's a flipping Furby. Look at that. It's a Furby face and it's its beak, and I'm literally expecting it to just start talking any second now. It's the spitting image, I tell you. Anyway, right, so what does this thing do? Well, we have a bunch of outputs down here and we have one input chest. This is basically where we grind up all of our ores. So I've got a whole bunch of ores here that I've collected. Iron, gold, copper, and zinc. These are our main washable ones that we can do. We chuck them in the chest up here, and if I just chuck in one, you'll see it grinds it up in the grind wheels. It plops it down here and puts it on the conveyor belt just there, where we have some washing fans either side of it, double speed, to wash the things. And the thing in the back there only picks up the washed crush ore, i.e. nuggets. And if we have a little look around the back, we'll see that we put everything into this back bit. We've got a sorting system for iron nuggets, gold nuggets, and we've got copper and zinc over the other side there. Those come through these other bits. It's all quite compact. It's all quite weird and confusing. And then those four different ones go into these four basins. As you can see, each of the ores are in there already. And what happens is these crushers come chicking, ka-ching, ka-chink down, first crushing the nuggets into ingots, but then also crushing the ingots into blocks. You can see we've got these filters on each of these, which do iron ore and block there as well, which means the recipes we'll keep them in there, and underneath we have a filter for iron blocks, gold blocks, and so on, so that only those things get pulled out. So look, we've got 48 iron blocks. If we chuck a whole bunch more ores in, it's actually kind of fun if we just do like a couple of each one, because then you can see all the conveyor belts kind of move in all at once, and nuggets flowing throughout, bam, 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 like so. We can stand back, wait for the washing to occur, and we just see all these nuggets. There we go, nuggets flowing down. Crushers coming and crushing. It's the best Furby I've ever had. And what's so cool about this is it's not just an ore crusher, it's an everything crusher, right? We have a specific filter on the back here which will stop only the crushed ores from going through. So let's just say we want to crush some cobblestone into gravel, which we've done a little bit of already there. We can just chuck some cobblestone up, put it in the very front of the queue. The cobblestone is now getting crushed in the crushing wheels, and the gravel will literally just go swing and just go straight through. It will not get washed because we have a little filter system back here, which I'm now going to mess the whole machine up by taking, ba-dum, boom, all the crushed ores on the deny list there, which means they get held, which means they get washed until they turn into their nuggets. So you can see, like, the gravel and the flint and stuff, that's just going to go straight through. And that comes down the bottom there as well into our main chest. So five things get sorted, all the crushed ores get turned into nice compact blocks, and anything we want crushed just gets put straight in here, except for this stuff. Don't worry about that. That's because we got rid of the filter quickly. Oh, I ruined it. I ruined the fabricator. We've also got our hands on a speedometer and a stressometer as well, which, boy, you tell me, in real life, that would come in real handy. If we plop this thing on, you can see that this little mini network here has a stress capacity of 4,000, but it's only got 2,000 and something remaining, which means we can actually speed this whole thing up. That's how it works. The faster it goes, the more stress it takes. So we have this little thing over here, which is a speed combobulator. I don't know what it's called. We can scroll this up quicker. It's going 32 revolutions per minute. Maybe if we double it to 64, that is going quick. Oh my goodness me, the Furby is going crazy. Yeah, he's a lot quicker now. He's double as quick, and the stress... There is only 128 stress units remaining, so we're pretty much at maximum speed right now with the little windmill that we have going on here. We'd have to add some more windmill blades to this thing, make it taller or something, if we wanted to speed this up anymore. But I'm telling you, this is probably the fastest it needs to go. That all I can see is the Furby. Okay, the greatest thing ever might have just occurred. I have learnt that hopefully... we can pick up mob spawners, and that means placing them back down wherever we like to create an uber mega duper spawner. That's its official name. And it's basically using the technology that we played around with last time, these cart loading things. What are they called? Cart assemblers. Right, exactly. If we pop one of these down here with this on top of it, and then the cart inside, and then all we have to do is power the thing. Boop. Excellent. So that, oh, that's turned the torches into entities as well. All right, fair enough. I didn't use glue. Then we can pick up the cart. Please work. Excellent. Now I believe I have the spawner in the minecart, in the thing. What are we in these chests? Oh, an apple. And then we do almost the reverse just without the lever to put it down anywhere we like. Look at that. We got a mob spawner in our house now. Furby, what do you think of this spawner? It's perfect. All we'd have to do is get rid of the torches and yeah. Things be spawning. And here is how we are gonna achieve that. We're gonna go for a mahoosive 3x3x3. That's 27 blocks worth of spawners in the middle of a ginormous spawning room. We're gonna put some conveyor belts down on the floor to bring them all to one space. It's gonna be like a very traditional mob spawner, except cubed? Yeah, cubed. And that means I have to dig out this 13x13 hole, like, I don't know, 10 blocks down or something? That's a lot of blocks. I'm not going to do that crazy maths. Timesing 9x3 was hard enough. We are going to be using drills to do our hard work for us. A whole bunch of them. In fact, 36 of them. Why is maths happening today? Are we going to be pointing these downwards? Are we going to be driving them down into the ground to hopefully dig this whole thing out? I mean, 36 is a 6x6. We've got 13x13, so we can probably do 4/4 of it and then just kind of get rid of some of the other bits. I need to work out how to flip these around the other way, though. Aha! Oh, I had it. Okay, perfect. Like that, we can put a chassis on top, and we will do a massive drill. This is a drill, I repeat. This is a drill, everybody. A really, really big one at that as well. And we're going to try and hand crank this massive extendo piston all the way down. We've got this layer of chassis here that will hopefully push all the layer of drill all the way down, hopefully 6 blocks. I think, yeah, pole length 6, that should go all the way down and through. I'm just hoping that we can power this really, really simply with a crank. I'm going to be cranky if this doesn't work, so let's try. Oh, did it work? I think I might have to do a lot more cranking than that. Ah, well, there you go. No such luck. We couldn't do it. I am definitely very mad now. You can't hand crank your way through life, folks. Sometimes you got to just get a little bit more power, a little bit more of a water wheel, I think we're going to use. Oh, it's so ugly. Please don't look. Don't look at my gross, ugly water wheel. It'll get the job done. I hope we can add a couple more if we need to. Oh. Okay. We have it. We had movement. We were just powering it the wrong way around. This is way quicker. Yeah! Extend! Fantastic. Right, we can put that round the other way. I just used a gearbox to reverse the shaft. There we go. Now it's going to pull that back upwards. Fantastic. Oh, it wasn't a sticky piston. Whoops. Okay, I'll manually go down, collect that. We'll do that 3 more times, and then, yeah, we'll have a massive big room. It's terrifying. It's cool. It's terrifying, though. It's quite beautiful. It's like a ballet of drills going down slowly into the floor. Oh, look, the dirt breaks quicker than the stone. I guess that makes sense. Is that going to happen again? It is. All right. Look, I'm learning things. I'm learning all the things. Like, stay away from the drill when it comes down. You too, zombie. You too. Now we have a beautifully decorated little dungeon hole, complete with mossy bricks, because of course, it's a dungeon after all, and with the big 3x3x3 cube in the middle, this thing is going to be an absolute monster. You can see we've pretty much got the four blocks either side of the very edge ones, so it's kind of a bit bigger than we need to have a normal spawner, because it's bigger in the middle, if that makes sense. All of the spawners have all of their normal room to be able to spawn in, and you can see we're going to have to put the top ones in first, because we always have to add it in from below, so to speak. So the first one will go somewhere like there. Beautiful. Is that in? It's already in. Oh, perfect. Okay, so we can break this away. Everything falls down. Fantastic. That is number one, and I guess we don't need the torches on it anymore because we're in direct sunlight. I definitely wanted to keep this thing open to the sun so we didn't have to worry about skeletons and zombies and things landing on our head while we are still building this, but yes, yes, yes. Oh, the torch. Interesting. Did I put that torch in the top middle, or did it just go there? I don't know. We don't need any of them. Skeletons, keep on whizzing around like a tornado, because we are going to be farming you up. Now, the floor I did not decorate. I just kind of made it nice smooth stone, because all we're going to do is cover it in conveyor belts anyway, like so, all over to one edge, all over to one corner. And I think mobs are kind of like items where they'll kind of wait their turn once they've kind of latched on to a conveyor belt, as long as they're not tracking anything else. They'll kind of like go to the edge here, and if another mob's coming down, it will kind of like give way. I should have like stop signs along the edge of all of these, but I don't need them because they're so nice and neat. But you can see they're going pretty slowly and they're very much in range of the spawner. And these spawners, once they see a certain amount of zombies in a certain area, or skeletons, or sorry, monsters, whatever we have, it basically turns off. So you normally want to get these mobs out of there as quick as possible. And you usually do that by dropping them down like 6 or 7 blocks. But we can change the speed of these conveyor belts very, very easily. I've got some water wheels down here that are doing their watery wheel thing, spinning around like crazy. We've got 3 of them, and this little speed combobulator thing again. If we add a stressometer to this, we can see, okay, so look, it's using about 200 of its stress units, and it has a little bit more to go. So we can crank this up a little bit more. We see the stress units start going up. We're only using 37%. We can go a little bit quicker. A little bit quicker until the dial goes right up into the red there. Can we go one more? One more speed crank. Oh, I need to scroll. Huh. Oh my, we're using the full capacity. 100%. Oh my goodness. So we cannot add anything more to this system. But you can see it is whizzing around like crazy. And it's true. It's pretty quick. If we hop on ourselves, you can see we whiz by quite fast. These things can go even quicker though. So you know what? I think we might add a few more water wheels and completely speed this up to top speed. I might have done a ridiculous thing. Look at this. I think it's light speed. I think that's what the dial read. I am going to go down and test ride it myself, but I'm pretty sure this is going to clear the mobs out more than quick enough. Let's go in the furthest spot possible. If a mob spawns right here, how quickly do they get whizzed on by? Okay, yeah. That's quick. That is whizzy. Oh my good, that you scared me. Hello, you've clearly ridden this before me. And after a whole bunch of time looking, I managed to find myself a zombie, another skeleton one, and also a spider one, which is stupid because they don't fit. But we do have 2 more to go. I also know where a baby spider one is, which they might work. I'm not sure if they're going to climb up the walls, but I don't know. And I also know where a blaze one is, so we might go and grab that as well. I'm a bit scared about how I even get down there and add these to it now, but I guess I'll figure that out. And boop. And boop. Lovely. I instantly hear spawns as soon as I put the last block in. Okay, hopefully we come down here. We should be nicely in range. There are legs. I'm glad I see legs. Excellent luck coming in right now. We found a baby spider spawner that we're going to nab. And then just down here around the corner, I found yet another little skelly one. So we have an extra skelly. I'm going to head... We're going to head over to the nether as well. I think I know exactly where a blaze spawner is too. And then we'll test out exactly what the rates are like with those. Okay, there's the blaze spawner. We just got to get in, get out. Well, get the thing first in between, but kill this guy super quick. Don't fire me, don't fire me, don't fire me. I asked you please nicely. Okay, get the thing under the thing. Don't break the spawner. That would be terrible. Place, place. Cart. Okay, lever. Down. Wrong place, down. Okay, back and quick. Something's going to come up behind me, I just can tell. Is that it? I think it works. Okay. Very good. Take everything, and we are out of here like a flash. Oh. It is also starting to get not that easy putting these things in place. Oh, no, that's the blaze. We're going to do the blaze second. We got the baby spiders. Excellent. Pick that up and pick this up again. Please don't fall off. Nice. And then we're going to be putting the blaze over here, which I think can still spawn even though there's sunlight. So this has got bad news written all over it. But, you know, it's we got to do it. It's our job. Okay. And I break that as well. I don't care that it all falls down. And we are going to ride down and go this way. And we are safe. Where's the block? Safe. Okay, I'm hearing the blaze and everything. There they are. Okay, so they do drop down. And as long as they don't see me, they just don't fly at all anywhere. Perfect. So before we seal this up for the final time today, we can see three skelly spawners, a blaze, a zombie, and a baby spider one, which is going to cause all kinds of trouble. The blazes are going nuts already. But if we just hang out down here, hopefully we can see the fruits of our labor. I might just sort of stay here for five, ten minutes or so and see exactly what gathers. Quickly checking out what it looks like from the inside. With special cam, you can see things spawning super quick and just getting absolutely whiplashed out of there and funneled straight down into the hole. It does work for baby spiders as well. You see them just go straight down. They do try and climb out a little bit, but they don't make it very far before they go down the hole completely. So yeah, the more we add, the more they're just gonna spawn because every one of them has their own refresh timer. Oh, there's a baby spider and down he goes. You barely see them. It's like a few seconds and they're gone. The view from down here is also rather nice as well. I obviously need some kind of mob softener or something like that to bring them down to a one-hit kill because I want to have some XP coming from this, as well as all the lovely bones and blaze rods, and I guess rotten flesh. Let's just not be mean to the zombies. How did you escape? Okay, so I learned that a baby spider can escape from there too. So we need to do some changes still, but ultimately, this has got the workings of Ultimate Mega Spawner, so yes. So there we go, the Mega Spawner Cube project fully underway. Those blazes getting completely whipped out from under their feet. If you enjoyed the episode, remember you can like, comment, subscribe, all those amazing things to help the video out. Do appreciate the support. As always, a massive, massive thank you to my wonderful patrons as well who have helped to support me through thick and thin. They are an awesome bunch of people. Thank you all so very much for your wonderful support. But until the next episode, a good, a bye.